The next thing we're going to talk about is reading and setting numbers on the abacus. Before beginning to teach kids how to calculate problems on the abacus, it's important for them to be able to read numbers that are already set on the abacus and to be able to set numbers themselves. When reading and setting numbers on the abacus, the students need to have a strong working knowledge of place value and to be able to locate the correct place value columns that they're working in. They'll need to know that the number 15 is made up of 1 10 and 5 ones. They'll need to know that the number 23 is made up of 2 10s and 3 ones. And they'll need to know that the number 564 is made up of 500s, 6 10s, and 4 ones, so they can be able to set them in the correct place value columns. Although computation for the counting method usually starts with the ones and continues to the higher numbers, when you're setting and reading problems, it may be preferable for your students to read them from the big numbers to the little numbers, like 564, because that's typically how their sighted peers will be reading them as well. So we're going to talk about reading numbers that are already set on the abacus, and we're going to look at the abacus, and we're going to look at the problem that is set. And there, you would really want your students to be able to read these numbers that are set on the abacus.